I'm Father Paul Reagan Talavera. I'm from Concepcion, Tarlac, and presently I'm assigned at the Priory of St. Thomas Aquinas as the parish priest of Santisimo Rosario Parish, USD. I was ordained on August 6, 2011, and I was assigned as assistant treasurer here at the Santo Domingo Parish first. And then after ordination, I was assigned in Surabaya, Indonesia, Redemptor Mundi Parish as the assistant parish priest, and also as acting formator for our aspirants, no, Indonesian aspirants. After 1.5 years, I was assigned in Angelicum School in Iloilo, and I served Angelicum for 7 years. I was first treasurer, and then I also served as the guidance counselor of the school. And then towards the end of my stay there, I was the principal of Angelicum School in Iloilo. And then last year, 2019, I was assigned in UST as the parish priest of Santisimo Rosario Parish. So basically, since the Santisimo Rosario Parish is very unique because it's situated inside the University of Santo Tomas, so there is a special ministry that we do for the students, particularly celebrating Mass and the priest assigned in the priory hearing confessions, and of course each priest assigned in the different colleges. And particularly because it's inside the university, we have this advantage because there are a lot of youth coming inside the parish. Now it's a challenge because there are no students in the university. They all went home. So konti lang yung mga tao sa parish. No? And we continue with what we had been doing before, but in a different way. Like for example, celebrating Mass online, having our morning prayers, everything. No? On the territory of the parish na extend outside the UST campus. No? Actually, FEU is included. No? And then at the back, Laonglaan Street, no? The area where you buy your flowers. And then it extends to the Riles, Algeciras Street. And then, of course, in front is Loyola and España. So the parish, like any other parish, it has baptism, marriages done, except funerals, no? Because it's a consideration to the students that it's quite morbid, no, to see coffins entering the university. No?
So you do not do funeral?
So we do not do funeral masses, no, for even before. It's not included. For those who need funeral services, we go to their houses. No? Particularly in the area, they do their wakes in the barangay. No? So we go to the barangay hall or the chapel outside. Actually, we have 3 chapels outside, and they do their wake there. So be blessed. No? But most commonly, we go to the houses. No? And then, if we cannot celebrate Mass, especially now during the pandemic, we just have the funeral blessing. No? Para mabasbasan lang bago ilibing. No? Kasi the situation now, no, as we all know, no, medyo kailangan ng safety din natin. Most of those who are being blessed sa bahay naman ay cremated, for example. So, yun. Ang sa kanila, no, at least man lang, no, before malibing, napakahalaga ng blessing. Sa ngayon, no, I think what is very much needed is to have contact, no, especially with the people around. Because if you see UST, it's very exclusive. No, you just cannot enter the chapel, no, without passing to the security. So that is one thing. No, marami yung mga nahihirapan. No? So I think one challenge is how to go out and really see the needs of the parishioners outside the parish, no? Especially those who are in need materially. No? As we all know, now there are a lot of people without work, no? Unemployed, and even the basic needs, no? Napakahalaga. And there is also an increase of street dwellers, no? Just going around, no? España, Pinoval, Dapitan. No? So that is one challenge, no? How to address, no, issue, no? Particularly helping these people. No? Well, initially, it's very short. It's a short term, goal to have feeding programs, for example. No, I just learned recently because one of our Legion of Mary members, no, he has a very active ministry with the street dwellers. You cannot give them supplies that they have to cook because in the first place, they don't have a kitchen. No, so you give them food which they could immediately eat, bread, Yakult, no, those things. So in a sense, para siyang short term, pangtawid gutom lang talaga. But after the pandemic, no, I'm planning also to talk with our PPC on how to address and give them long-term project, no, like for example, livelihood or other things, no, that we can do to help them. It seems like there are a lot of people, no, that could be involved in the parish because it is in the university. And I think the challenge is how to invite more people to become active, especially the young people. Because I do not know, no, by observation, we only have to give them a chance, no, especially the youth. They have a lot of potential. No, for example, they can do TikTok, they can do vlogs, they can do a lot of things, no, with their creativity. No, so how to address or how to help them, no, use, no, that creativity for the church, no, particularly for evangelization. So as we said, no, it's a parish within the university, but when you try to count how many youth are actually active inside the parish, there are very few. So I think that is one thing. No, if we could engage them, we could invite them, especially in basic ecclesial communities. Now, around the campus, there are a lot of condominiums. No, and those who are original residents of Sampaloc, no, are not there anymore. No, yung mga usual BEC concept natin. So I think it is high time, for example, to have ministries not just along the streets, but along inside condominiums. No, halimbawa, instead na it's horizontal, no, we have a vertical kind of model in order to reach out to them. No, because if they are our parishioners, no, they should know. No, some of them don't even know that there is a parish inside the university. So I think one good thing is to invite them, to introduce ourselves, no, to go out. No, because sometimes the tendency for us is to wait for them. But I think it's time for us to go out, introduce the parish, and tell them, no, may ganitong ministry. No, pwede kayo maging lector, commentator, altar server, choir, for example. They could even be members of the social media, no, ministry of the parish, no, emerging ministries. Actually, medyo yun dumadami. And as I said before, even counseling, because you can easily open up, talk to your fellow students, no, not approaching a formal counselor, no, pero yung mga kakwentuhan lang, no, to help us, because mahirap yung walang kausap, no, lalo na ngayong pandemic, no, especially those are lockdown, no, they weren't able to go home, for example, no, maghahanap at maghahanap ng kausap. No, so yun yung isang I think important, that ministry of accompaniment, no, accompanying young people, no, even professors, even old people, no, lahat, no, and so that they would feel, no, that the church is really there, no, accompanying them with their faith, no, with their faith life.